Good morning, everyone. I think only the people up front heard what Pat said to Tamika when she dropped this on the floor. Turn over, Tamika. That's it. It's my pleasure to welcome everyone to a much anticipated day at the University of Tennessee. It's a goosebumps day on Rocky Top. So we have an opportunity collectively to salute Pat Summitt. We will formally dedicate today the Pat Summitt Plaza, and we will unveil the centerpiece, a beautiful statue of a beautiful woman. Today is a celebration Today is a celebration of Pat's legendary career as a coach. Before I make a few opening remarks about Pat, I do want to recognize another woman who's with us today who, like Pat, positively impacted the lives of many, many young women and became highly respected nationally for her tireless efforts, particularly on behalf of women's athletics. She made a difference in Tennessee, and she made a difference for young women everywhere nationally. Joan Cronin, would you please stand up? I want to applaud a few people who were directly responsible for this beautiful plaza that we dedicate this morning. Merritt Construction, for many of us, myself and Donna and Dara and Chris Fuller and others, we could watch every day. And it made you fill up with pride to watch it unfold and become the first class piece of construction that it is. We have a time-lapse camera that has been up on that patio so that we could appreciate for many, many years the hard work that went into this exceptional job. Merritt Construction and Marv House, thank you. Carol Johnson Architects and Sean Vassington and Studio 4 Design and Mike Keller, let's give them a hand for doing an absolutely outstanding job. I also want to recognize Vice Chancellor Chris Cimino for his leadership role in this historic project. And obviously, it goes without saying that David Addicks, and you'll see this in just a little bit, did an absolutely magnificent job sculpturing the statue of Pat. A debt of gratitude certainly is owed to the Laporte and Hillary families. Scott and Debbie Hillary provided the lead gift for the plaza in honor of Scott's father, Bill, and in memory of his mother, Evelyn. The Laportes, Chris and Q, Quinita, Joe and Hope, Sam and Marlo, Steve and Liz provided the gift that made the statue possible from a funding perspective. Many others here today contributed to the Pat Summitt Plaza. Many of you contributed to make this goal a reality. And many athletic staff members worked tirelessly to make it come to fruition, especially people like Kevin Zerker, Donna Thomas, and Dara Worrell spent countless hours for us to be standing here today. Someone who is very, very close to Pat shared with me that shortly after we announced our intentions to both Pat and Tyler that we wanted to build this plaza and have a statue bearing Pat's name, and that it would be constructed as the centerpiece of the plaza, that Pat's response was, "Can you believe they're doing this for me? I'm just a basketball coach." Yes, Pat, we're honoring you today in perpetuity for your unfathomable accomplishments as the winning basketball coach to ever coach the game. However, we're recognizing we're recognizing you for much, much more than that. These women here today, your former players, represent only a sampling of the women you've touched, the women you've impacted in such a significant way. You were their coach. So through that experience, they grew, and they grew immensely. But more than that, you were their mentor. And through mentoring them, you literally shaped their lives, as you did thousands of other young men and young women alike who wanted to emulate everything you stood for the standard of excellence you set, and the way you demanded it in an uncompromising manner. And you're much more than that. You're Tyler's mom. And the man that that young man has become is a testament to you as mother. So, Pat, with all due respect, you are not and never were just a basketball coach. Allow me, before introducing our chancellor, to highlight this basketball coach's accomplishments for just a moment. And this is just, again, a sampling of what this woman has accomplished. Pat is the winningest coach in NCAA basketball history with 1,098 career wins. She won 84% of the games she coached. Eight times she was SEC Coach of the Year. Five times she was the National Naismith Coach of the Year. She was named the Naismith Coach of the Century in 2000. She won 32 SEC championships, 16 in the regular season, and 16 tournament championships. She coached to a gold medal the 1984 U.S. Olympic team. She's been inducted into numerous halls of fame. It's harder to find one she's not in than one that perhaps she's getting ready to go in. She was selected as the coach of the NCAA's 25th anniversary team. She was Sports Illustrated Sportswoman of the Year in 2011 at a wonderful ceremony in New York City. She won 8 national championships, and every Lady Vol basketball player who played for Pat Summitt and completed her eligibility got their degree. So to say that Pat Summitt is just a basketball coach would be like me trying to convince you that Michael Jordan is just a basketball player. It is now my pleasure to introduce the gentleman who is providing for all of us on this campus outstanding leadership, Chancellor Jimmy Cheek.
Thank you very much, Dave. And before I get started, I would like to recognize the president of the University of Tennessee system, Dr. Joe DiPietro, and his wife, Deb. Deb and Joe, we greatly appreciate everything you do for the University of Tennessee, Knoxville, your tremendous support for us, and please stand and let's recognize them. Today, we honor the greatest basketball coach ever, Pat Summitt. All of us here today are here to honor her, and we also call her Pat. She wants it that way, actually. She wants her friends and her family and her coworkers and her team members to call her Pat. And Pat, you're known worldwide. Matter of fact, I was in China recently, and two or three people came up to me and said, "How's Pat?" And I knew exactly who they were talking about. She's never stood on ceremony or demanded respect, but she's definitely earned it. She also has demanded excellence on the court and in the classroom. And if you don't believe that, let me tell you a little story about a person who's an All-American and an Olympic gold medalist, Bridget Gordon. As the story goes, the team was in Hawaii, Pat, and Pat was looking through the players' grades. And when Pat got to Bridget's grades, there were no grades recorded. And as you can imagine, this did not sit well with Pat Summitt. She told Bridget, "I'm so mad at you, I don't know if I'll ever forget it. I'm going to put you on a raft and send you back to the mainland. And I'm going to punch a hole in the raft." Now, that's pretty tough talk for one of the best players ever on our team, right? And now for the rest of the story. It turns out that Bridget had an overdue library book and a library fine. She had a hold on her grades, and come to find out, she had done pretty well in the semester. But as a result of that, she didn't have to get on that raft. Be funny with that hole in it. I'm not sure how she'd get back to the mainland, Pat. But I hope you have got over that situation. Pat's commitment to academics is unmatchable. She's one of a kind. Pat Summitt is a Tennessean by birth and a Tennessee volunteer by choice. And we're delighted you made that choice, Pat. This fantastic statue, which you will see just in a few minutes, will stand as an inspiration to everybody who passes by here. Our students, our faculty, our alumni, our staff, and anyone that just comes on this campus and set foot on our campus and sees this statue, that will be inspiring to her, to them, because of what she did. She inspires everybody by what she's accomplished, but more importantly, by how she did it. And she did it with hard work, persistence, integrity, style, humility, and a great deal of extremely high expectations. And Pat, we appreciate you for that. You've really inspired us greatly. She's honored her roots, her family, and her university. And it's been never about Pat Summitt. It's always been about her student athletes and the University of Tennessee, Knoxville. And Pat, I'm honored and humbled to be part of this day today in your history and in the history of this great university. You have touched many, many more lives than any of us will ever realize. And this statue and your legacy will inspire many generations to come. Yes, you are the greatest basketball coach ever, but you're also a great human being, and we greatly appreciate you being a Tennessee volunteer. Thank you for staying with us a long period of time as our coach. Thank you for all you've done for this great university. And thank you for being Pat Summitt.
Speaking of being one of Pat's greatest players, and it would take a long time to go through that list, but we are blessed here today to have one of our most recent, this past year, as a matter of fact, only a few weeks ago, one of our latest inductees into our Lady Vol Hall of Fame. She did not want to miss this and made every effort that it took to be here to be a part of this historic day as we honor Pat Summitt in perpetuity. It is my pleasure to introduce, she needs no introduction, Tamika Catchings.
Thank you. It's definitely an honor for me to be here, and knowing what this day represents, I think all of us wanted to be here. I don't stand up here for myself. I stand up here for all the ladies behind me, for all the people that have worked underneath Pat and her leadership and just everything that she brought, not only to us as basketball players, but even more important, as people. I know for me personally, Pat, I just want to say thank you. This is an awesome day to see so many people here from so many different walks, all of us here for one main reason, and that's to celebrate you. Pat's such an amazing woman, and I think when everybody asks me, what is it that you have learned from her? It's not necessarily being a great basketball player, but yes, that is something I definitely learned about being a great basketball player. Playing defense, yes, number one on my list. Wow. Yeah, it did take me a while, but I got it. But I think even more so, just being a great person. I think when you look at all of us, and all the things that we've been able to accomplish, not only on the basketball court, but even off the court. We got coaches, we got entrepreneurs, we got mothers, we got a little bit of everything. And I think for all of us, we learned about what it takes to be a leader, what it takes to be a great woman, what it takes to be a great lady, what it takes to have character, what it takes to have poise, how not to buckle under adversity. a lot of different things that we all learn. And I think being here, this statue that we're about to present, this is all, it all embodies you. It all embodies everything that you've given all of us. And even for us standing here today and coming from all different places, nobody wanted to miss it. For those of them that are overseas, that couldn't make it home, everybody is here, everybody is celebrating in this statue that represents you. So we just want to say thank you for all that you've done. Thank you for all that you've given all of us. Thank you for just the joy. I mean, it's amazing. This is awesome to look out and see all these people here that are here for you. So thank you, Pat. Thank you for everything. I love you.
You know, as we visited with the former players a little bit before coming over, I mentioned to a small group of them, you know, we got to hold the rain off. And they said, Mr. Hart, this is Pat Summitt. It's not going to rain. And they were right. This next young man, in all of my career in intercollegiate athletics, meeting so many wonderful young men and women who are student athletes, this young man immediately struck me as being mature beyond his years. He learned so much from his mom, not just about basketball, but about being a good person. And trust me when I tell you that if there's a greater pride in the world than watching an offspring reach his or her potential, Pat has enjoyed that. It is my pleasure to introduce Tyler Summitt.
Every moment is a teaching moment. I'll say it again. Every moment is a teaching moment. A very common phrase that my mom used and still uses to this day. And I think that it was something instilled in me that I will never forget. Those who know mom know that she's a teacher. That's what she is. And I think I would get the stare today if I didn't use this moment as a teaching moment. Today is possible in my mind because of three values that my mom had. Three values that she was consistent with and instilled in everybody around her. And because of today and because of this, those three values and her legacy will be remembered forever. The first value is to compete. To be the best you can be, not just on the court, but more importantly, off the court. Not talking about the scoreboard or the national championships. Talking about being the best you can be every day. This is why people are successful after the program. I mean, look at Holly. Great career and dominating right now with her team. Look at Mickey and Tamika. Absolutely, absolutely. Tamika and Mickey DeMoss. Not only did they do well here, but they win a WNBA championship. Look at, absolutely. Look at a lady like Michelle Marciniak, who thrived here and is now thriving in the business world. Those cows never took a day off, so we weren't allowed to either, were we?
That's true.
But that doesn't matter unless you have the second value, and that's character. Do things the right way, Ty Man. Do things the right way. I think a lot of mom's definite dozen, the responsibility, the respect, the loyalty, the communication pieces boil down to character. And there was always somebody that we could look to that had that character. An example of this is when I bypassed character and communication. The right thing to do when I was 8 years old was to always tell my mom when I would go and do something. So I go down to the dock to go fishing, and I did not communicate. And My accountability was being spanked from every step to the dock back up to the house. Now, I could say that I was tough and that didn't bother me. There are 42 steps from the dock to the house. But most importantly, her third value. Now, if you're listening, say I am. Family. Family. That's what she always instilled in me. Surround yourself with great people. Surround yourself with great people. And I didn't fully understand that until I met my wife, Andy, but now I truly know to surround yourself with great people, and that's what it's all about. And so there are many thanks in order. So first and foremost, to Jesus, our Lord and Savior, my mom's favorite verse is Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through him who gives me strength. Second to our family and friends, and I cannot tell you all how much loyalty there is with our family and friends. It's absolutely incredible, and we want to thank everybody that's here and everybody that was unable to be here. We want to thank Dave Hart, Joan Cronin, the entire Tennessee family, as well as past administrators for making this possible and always supporting Mom. Thanks to the Hillary and Laporte families and so many other supporters that made this possible. Thank you to Mom's present, past staffs, and everybody that has ever helped her do what she does. And then the phrase that I heard after every single championship, to the greatest fans in the nation, thank you for always supporting her and supporting still through the Pat Summitt Foundation. And it means so much to us. But last, to the players. I never scored a point for the Lady Vols.
That's right.
I always heard that. And it's these young ladies that did the hard work. And not only is Mom honored by this statue, but every single one of her players. So I challenge you, first, to look at those three values in each and every one of your lives, whether it's sports or not. Family. Who do you surround yourself with? Competing to be the best you can be every day, and then doing things the right way. So to wrap up, I would like to reflect on what I know makes my mom smile and light up more than anything. And it's when she sees that something she taught help somebody else. This past weekend, we went to Vanderbilt, and it made her happy that we won.
Yeah.
But as we're there with the Marquette team, I told her, this happened because of you. I used what you taught me to make this happen, and I saw her light up more than anything. And now, because of today, every person who sees this can remember what she stands for. They will have a Pat Summitt teaching moment, and nothing could make my mom smile more. Thank you so much, and God bless.
I never knew that we had enough people in here. But this is a great day, and Tyler and I have, we've obviously been together for a long time, and I just want everybody to know that for me, today, it's not about me. It's about everyone out here that loves the University of Tennessee And we just hope and pray that we can continue to do good things. And Tyler has been a rock for me, and I appreciate him. And for that, I want everybody to know how much I appreciate what's happened here today. And I don't think I'll ever forget it. And I love you all. Thank you.
Now, Donna, Thomas, and Dara insisted on this participation from everyone who's here. So I'm going to ask you in just a moment to count down from three. Should be easy enough. 3, 2, 1. At that moment, the people up here, Tamika, you might need to be the one. You're the most athletic. You might need to get this done. We're going to unveil the statue of our coach, our legend, our ambassador, and our friend, Coach Pat Summitt. We thank you all so very much for being a part of this wonderful, wonderful day at the University of Tennessee. We appreciate very much that we do indeed have the best fans in the country, and we're blessed to be able to be a part of it. Thank you for being here.